Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Rabi-Ribi. In the last episode, we fought Kotrine, we helped Shauna get used to the mainland. So, now we've come back down to the volcanic caverns, and now we're gonna go down this pit and see if we can find Miriam. Down we go! The heck did I just watch? I thought the thing was gonna loop! Okay then. This is certainly different. Very different. Am I playing the finale of Aria of Sorrow again? Because this is all looking very familiar to me. All these echoey effects do not help. And hi, Coco! Okay, yeah, this is, I guess, kind of a mini where have we been kind of level. The only level I can think of right now that has this sort of a gimmick where you fight previous bosses is the final level of Mega Man X8, where you fight a bunch of Sigma clones. Yep, this is definitely Aria of Sorrow right here. Giant cactus. So far, it's not too bad. I mean, I'm not finding any items, but it's not very difficult to navigate. Okay, so we have Coco. Does this mean Pandora will show up? Oh no, we just have bunny cultists. Ow. Oh, hi, Shuri! You're packing some serious heat today! Yeah, you're like a mini-boss of sorts. And you're down, finally. And you know what? I still never found those other two shot types. Huh. Oh well. Bees. And bunny cultists. Bomb everything. Excuse me. I want to be thorough. I want to be thorough. I need to be thorough. Oh, more enemies. Maybe if I just run you, let you just run off screen. Okay, fair enough. Good. Okay, nothing there. Oh, Kotri again. Ah! Her satellites are worthless now. Alright then. This looks like a pretty straightforward level. I don't know what it was I killed, but that's one less enemy to deal with. Bees! I'm guessing Rita is up next. Yep, there's Rita. Yeah, they only used like one or two attacks they used in their original boss fight. So, nothing to worry about, I don't think. I think this is just going to become one long, winding cavern from another dimension. I guess you could say this is a thing from another world. I see you up there. Oh, stop jumping. Also, now I'm curious. Are these bunny cultists just illusions too, or are they the real thing? It's hard to say. I'm guessing they're just illusions too. Does not help that their underground base thing looks a lot like one of the levels in Aria of Sorrow. Oh no, I forgot to do something. I forgot to link the Steam page on my other video. I better fix that. I don't want the developers getting angry at me. Yeah, you're becoming a pain. So here, have some green. I like the green shot, but it has way too much of an opening curve to it. You can only really use that as a distance. At a distance. Rotated the wrong way. That always froze me off. Okay, Golden Riverbank. These little ninjini cats. And the Shuri's back. This time with different attacks. firing off all those Rinkas. You know what could have made this game a little more interesting? If it would have behaved a little bit more like a Mega Man. Because you fight all these bosses in different orders, and you can get... And it'd be nice if you can get, like, their special attack or something from them. That's just me. I mean, you'd have to pretty... You have to change the gameplay a fair bit to make them... To make it resemble Mega Man, but I think it would be kind of cool. Kind of like a Metroidvania Megamari kind of thing. Also, you are absurdly durable! Fireballs for the win. I didn't have to kill her, but I did. Seems these clones also give up a fair amount of money, too. Oh, now we got this, laboratory setting. Hey, it's the Screw Bombers again! Been a while since I saw those things. Ah, yeah, sure, just... do that. And... oops, I... well, whatever. Oh dear. They're just everywhere. Well, hey, I'm getting a reading on an item. Maybe. Okay, yeah, I'm basically revisiting old areas again, but I don't mind this so much. It's interesting. Gives you a new perspective on things and allows people to make more interesting levels with the previous assets. Wait. Okay. Well, there is an item in this area. I'm pretty sure of it. Okay. Expecting either Sassini, what's her face, Sayaro, or the hologram security system. Or they can just throw more screw bombers at me, that works. Oh, right, there's that thing, I forgot about him. Mr. Box. Whom is very easy to kill with a laser. Hey, hey, the Sky Bridge. And hey, Vanilla and Warrior Spaz. Yeah, let me just bomb my way out of that one. That's the first time I had to use the bunny amulet outside of a boss fight. I inflicted severe contact damage to her! And she just exploded! I guess that puts a whole new meaning on the term to body someone. Oh, right, you throw spears. And oh, right, you shoot lasers. Bye bye. Well, I must be getting somewhere. I'm kind of weaving back and forth, and I'm getting close to that one pre-highlighted room on the map. Hi, Fwomps. Run! Why'd I do that? Okay, just making sure. So, first we have chocolate, first we have vanilla, and now we're gonna have chocolate. I actually had a bit of chocolate before doing this video. I wanted to make sure I didn't get hungry while I was recording. I don't know if anyone has these particular kinds of chocolates in their region, but I really like those Russell Stover, you know, chews. And I also like the endangered species chocolate bars. Those are pretty good. You can usually get them for a nice price, too. Sometimes 2 for 1. Or rather, 2 for $4 or something. It depends on the area you live in, really. I mean, it really depends on where you live, but sometimes you can find chocolate at good prices. Hey, look, I discovered something non-gaming in a video. And hi, chocolate! Yeah, let's get you out in the open where you can be more easily dealt with. Eek! Yeah, you're just all kinds of spastic today, aren't you? Seriously! What? Oh, there you are. I was wondering what happened to you. And once again, I body her. Okay. Wow, just wow. That fire orb, I upgraded so... I think I upgraded to the point where it's maxed, and that just did an obscene amount of damage to them. The clones, I mean. The illusions. Alright, what's in this room? Whoa. Hi there, blatant, Okay, you're not exactly a rip-off of a particular room. Okay, there's nothing special down there, is there? Actually, why would this room have such a high place for me to... Why would this room look like this? Are they implying something here? Didn't mean to do that, but wow. Yeah, let's just body everyone! Okay. Let's see if there's anything. Yep! I thought so. There's an Easter egg here. I forgot what version the Easter eggs were added in. But it doesn't really matter now, because they're in the game now, and I'm gonna collect every single one of them still, and oh, goodness. Now this means I have to deal with Lilith, Enya, and Green and Blue Coatree. And of course, the fairies with the homing shots. And these homing bunnies. These bunny ghost things. Sorry about that, my ear was itchy. But yeah, there's Blue Coatree. Worth it. Get out of my face. I picked just the right sweet spot to hide in. And we finish it off with lasers. Leave no stone unturned. Leave no stone unturned? Wow. I can't English today. Hi there. Go away. Nope, nothing there, so up we go! Oh, the Ice Palace. Well, I know who I'm gonna be fighting next. You know what would also be an interesting mode to add to this game? An endless mode. Doggone it, Wander. Why'd you go down the wrong pipe? Ugh. Anyways, as I was saying, I think it'd be cool if there was like an endless mode to this game, like in Mega Man 9 and 10. You just keep fighting enemies and bosses until you perish. I almost collected all the items in this zone. Huh. Well, whenever I'm done with this zone, I'll try and find the last item. Oh, ay. Oh, you got backup! Oh yeah, I gotta be careful around you. You can inflict freeze. Yep. I am staying the heck away from you. Oh, why didn't I hit you? I hate these blasted icicle snowflake things. They're too durable. Ah! Stop staying in the air for... Yeah, okay. Arena used flame charge. It's super effective. Okay. Up we go. Hi, Lilith. I could just ignore you, but I kind of have this thing going on where I fight all the bosses, the mid-boss clones. Because why not? It's more interesting this way. It's just not just me walking through an area, just clobbering enemies. And you're just gonna stand there and shoot hearts at me, aren't you? Well, fine then. If you want to keep doing that, sure. Bye-bye. Okay. Moving on. Fighting him, he also gives me coins to heal me, so... Okay, we're in this zone. So that means, darn it, I can't tell who's who. All I know is that their names are Nixie and Nave, and, Neve. How do you say that name? Jeez. I'll have to look up how to pronounce their names, and oh crud, we got laser bees up ahead. Oh, why didn't you... Eh, I hate those things. I really do. Why do the bees have to be so cute yet so deadly in this game? Case in point. Bye. Bye, bye, bye. Strategy! Hello there! Oh crud, you got that curvy thing going on. Eh! Why do you have homing lasers?! Also, holy cow, that fire orb is so OP. Maybe I should just start using that instead of just... instead of wasting my time actually fighting the bosses. It's way too effective. Alright, yep. This is Pandora's area. Bye-bye. Get out of my face. Hi, Pandora. What are you gonna do to me? Oh, do your staff thing, okay. Yep. You keep doing that. Gonna come down? Yes, you are. Bye-bye. Of course, one last nuisance before the next room. All the rolling enemies! The sarcophagi. Please die. Thank you. Okay. Oh, well, you're not waiting. Okay, then. We'll fight off the Flower Girl, Miss Une. Okay, that's fair. Well, that completely wrecked her! Wow! Just wow! I use a single bunny amulet and it just completely wrecks her. Oh boy, now we got the underground zone. So that means Kotri. And lots of these red laser flowers of doom. Oh. Oh dear. Okay, yep, she's dead. It's raining lasers. Hallelujah, it's raining lasers. Wow, how'd I avoid that? Okay, sure, why not? Come on, jump so I can finish you. Okay, good. And of course, we're gonna probably fight Coco again. Coco I don't even know what to expect. There's a lot more of these, bunny cultists around here, so there's gotta be something to all this. There's gotta be something to all this. And what is with this setup here? Well, I can't do anything to it yet. Unless I... Well, since I'm here, I might as well do this. Okay, there we go. Nope. Oh well, I tried. Yeah, you just keep doing that, cats. Wait. I haven't fought Shauna yet. Oh no, does this mean the next zone is going to be the underwater one? Oh dear. That's going to be a little unpleasant. Because I remember fighting those blue bombers, the ones that fire those rings, those blue ring bombs, underwater. Oh, there's Coco again. And now she's using her drones. Ow. I probably should have seen this coming, because I forgot that she also appears in the forest as another boss. In the caverns as another boss. Oh, there's just too many enemies here! All the shrapnel. Yeah, you just stand there and take your punishment. Of course, the bombs don't actually die. Yeah, let's get out of here. Okay, now we're in the spectral cave. In fact, I'll have to go back there at some point. There was that one room I never was able to do anything with, the one that looked like an obvious boss room. Maybe that's where Ashuri is at. This is what you get for having a blind spot. Oops. This is what I get for blindly charging into combat and rolling when I didn't want to. Okay. Okay, then. We're fighting multiple ribbons. In fact, what happens if I use a bunny amulet here? Well, it displaces them, but doesn't do much else. Well, this is exciting, but it's also kind of boring, so let's just nuke them. Oh, okay, there we go. There. Probably could have saved myself a bit of trouble, and oh no, there's another one. Don't tell Coco! Ah, yes, the Max Money Trophy. Okay. I'm just gonna snipe you here. If your MP fill up, bam! Okay, moving on. Oh, frickin' the system again. Oh dear. Well, this is a very pleasant room to start off with. And wait, what? What the? Did I shoot something here? Weird. It's probably just glitching up. And hi, Sassini! And she's down. Sayara was probably next, and oh crud! Frickin' homing lasers. And there's the robot maids with their random antics. So these ones I can actually hurt with my hammer attacks. Wait. Okay, yeah, I gotta bomb my way through. Oh! Hello there! I don't even need to fight everyone at this point. I can just continue on through because I have maximum money. Hi, Sayaro. You and your homing missiles. And your homing everything else. Okay, yeah. Again, I could just body everything and just not give a darn. Oh, we have the Midnight Peak, I think it was called. Yes, I am fully aware that someone's trying to contact me. I am a little busy right now. Oh, sure, that's fair. And now I'm poisoned. Great. Well, not anymore, but still. I must be getting close to the end. Because this is one of the last areas I visited. Oh, of course, the underwater zone. This is gonna be pleasant. Okay, what do you got for me? Oh. Wait, okay, that's not Shauna. I thought that was Shauna. The green hair threw me off. Excuse my poor language. Okay, how deep am I in this thing? Holy cow, this is comprising most of the map. There'd better be a... Oh, hi, Shauna. And you're dead. Finally, a frickin' warp stone. This is a sight for sore eyes. I'm gonna make use of this, and I am going to go back to town and use all my money to buy all those upgrades. Well, the ones I can anyway, so... Don't expect me to buy out the entire store in one go. Alright, let's get all the health ups. Get all the regen ups. Well, most of them anyways. And let's get an attack up or two. Oh, just the one. Okay, fair enough. Not the limit! Okay, so... I apparently got the, 999 max HP achievement. Yep, I surpassed the limit because of, all the NPCs I have in town, so... In any case! Well... I'm sure they won't mind being in a group shot here. Anyways! Thank you for watching this, episode, and I will see you in the next one. And then, hopefully next time we'll be able to find Miriam and find out what happened to her. So, have a good evening, everyone, and be safe. a good day, rather. Whatever.